I'm Chris, and this is Go for English. Today, I'm gonna teach you how to use Quizlet to prepare online activities for your students.
Here you go to quizlet.com and you do the login.
As for many of these tools, there is a free version and a paid version. In this particular case, I use the paid version because there are some specific features that I like being able to record my voice for some of the vocabulary. But it's up to you to decide whether to use the free version or the paid version. So let's take a look at what I can do with the paid version.
So you go here to create. I'm going to write an activity about vocabulary related to pandemics, and the description is going to be COVID-19.
It's much easier for me to prepare my vocabulary list in advance on another tool like Word or Excel, because then I have time to do my research, check the students, and see which vocabulary I want to work on. Once this list is ready, I can import it onto Quizlet.
Then I click here, import from Word, Excel, Google Docs. I wrote my list on Excel. Then I go to my Excel. I already have my list. I copy, then I paste here. I just import. And as you can see, it already goes term, definition. What's so interesting about Quizlet is that it has a bank of images and it can actually read your text. So once you click on image, it really understands social distance and then you choose the image. One feature that I really like about the paid version of Quizlet is that I can add a voice recording. So all I have to do is click on the microphone. Quizlet provides the audio. Listen to the quality of their recording.
An object that may be contaminated with infectious organisms and serve in their transmission.
I can switch to the term. I usually prefer to have the recording of the term because usually the term is the unknown word. So I switch to term. I can listen to the Quizlet audio to see if I'm satisfied with it.
Fomite.
Or I can record.
Fomite.
Fomite. Once you've inserted the pictures and the audios for all your cards, then you can create your Quizlet. Then you receive a prompt if you want to share it. Now you can see all the things the students who get your Quizlet can do with your set. So the students can study your set in the form of flashcards, like this.
An object that may be contaminated with infectious organisms and serve in their transmission.
Then, learn is a multiple choice exercise. So then they have the definition and they have to choose the correct term. Let me get something wrong, then they tell me to study the word again. Write, they give you the definition and then you students actually have to write the correct answer. Correct. Let's say I misspell the word. Spell. Spell is a kind of dictation exercise. So they have to click on the audio icon.
Infectious.
If I misspell.
Social. S-O-C-I-A-L. Distance.
You have the correction and you have to try again. Test. The test is a combination of different formats. So you have to write the answer, then matching questions, then multiple choice, and true or false. Then there are games. This is a matching exercise, so I drag the word to the definition. Gravity. So gravity is the hardest, because then you have either to type in the definition or the term. It's better to write the term, because the definition is too long. So let's, like if I don't have time to type this one. Okay? And then, if you are in a classroom setting, you can play live like you would with Kahoot.
If you haven't watched my video about writing activities using Kahoot, please click on the card.
When you click on live, then you can decide how you want the students to play, if you want them to play on teams or individually, and then you create the game and you post it online. Here decide if you're gonna show the definition and ask for the term, or if you're gonna show the term and ask for the definition. And then the same way as Kahoot, you're gonna have a code, and then they can have the app to download, they can copy the game link and play on their devices.
As you could see, Quizlet allows you to do a lot of things with vocabulary, so make good use of this tool to make your classes even more interactive. If you have any questions or comments, please write them below. And if you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button. Please subscribe to the channel if you haven't already and share this video with other teachers who might benefit from this tool. Follow me on my social media, Go for English, on Instagram. Bye!